Hello, hello, hello. Good morning, everybody. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is so good. God is so great. He is marvelous. Hallelujah. God, you are King of Kings. You are Lord of Lords. God, you are Alpha and Omega. God, you are omnipresent. God, you are omniscient. Jesus Christ. God, you are everywhere. God, you are here. You are there. Jesus Christ. And today, God, I give you praise. I give you glory and I honor you, God. Oh, Jesus Christ, I just ask you to place the full armor protection over me, Father God, and those, God, who are underneath the sound of my voice and who are underneath the spirit of Christ in me and underneath the mind of Christ in me, Jesus Christ. I just ask you to place, hallelujah, God Almighty, the helmet of salvation over them, the breastplate of righteousness and faith, God. I just ask you to gird their loins with the belt of truth, God, shod their feet with the preparation of peace, Jesus Christ. I ask you, Father God, that I have a sword of the Spirit with them at all times, Jesus. Help them to pray without ceasing, Jesus Christ. Oh God, be a lamp to their path and a light to their feet in the name of Jesus Christ, y'all. Well, today I'm going to be reviewing Matthew chapter 4 and Mark chapter 6. This is in the New Living Translation Holy Bible. So I'm going to be reading Matthew chapter 4 and Mark chapter 6. Hallelujah. So I'm going to be praying. I'm going to be reading. I'm going to be declaring. Hallelujah. And I'm going to be allowing God to just speak in the name of Jesus Christ. So I decrease and I pray, Father God, that you will increase in the name of Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted there by the devil. Oh God, we just ask you, Father God, that what your spirit leads us, Jesus Christ, we just ask you, Father God, that you would be there in the name of Jesus Christ, God. We ask you, God, that your spirit will lead us into the marketplace, God. We ask you, Jesus Christ, that your spirit will lead us into multi-million dollars. We ask you, Jesus Christ, that your spirit will lead us into wealth and riches. God, we ask you that your spirit will lead us to silence the voice of our adversaries. God, we ask you that your spirit will lead us to silence the voice of our enemies in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God, for 40 days and 40 nights, he fasted and became very hungry. Oh God, we thank you for those who are fasting today, God. We ask you that their hunger and their appetite will decrease, God. May you feed them with the word of the Lord in Jesus' name. During that time, the devil came and said to him, if you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become loaves of bread. Y'all, I always pray, devil, do not speak to me in the name of Jesus Christ. Devil, do not speak to me in the name of Jesus Christ. If you're not coming to say something to me that's lovely, that's kind, and of a good report, then don't speak to me. I ask God to cause the devil to flee seven ways in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, Jesus, hallelujah, he told the devil no in the name of Jesus. He said no, Father God, no to the devil. No, Satan. The scriptures say people do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Oh God, I thank you for your mouth. That's why I always pray, God, allow me to hear your voice. God, incline your ear to my prayer. God, speak to me, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Then the devil took him to the holy city, Jerusalem, to the highest point of the temple and said, if you are the Son of God, jump off. For the scriptures say he will order his angels to protect you, and then they will hold you up with their hands in the name of Jesus Christ. So the devil took him to a high place and told him to jump off in the name of Jesus Christ. When God elevates us to high places, when God elevates us to multi-million dollars, when God elevates us to heal the sick, to heal the paralyzed, to heal those with legions of demons, when God elevates us, hallelujah, to have bachelor degrees, master degrees, doctorate degrees, when God elevates us to become advanced registered nurse practitioners, when God elevates us to become physicians, when God elevates us to become CNAs, when God elevates us to become nurses, when God elevates us to, hallelujah, to become midwives, when God elevates us to own our own family medical practice, hallelujah, we must continue to pray. We must continue to fast in the name of Jesus Christ. We can't jump off. We can't lose our mind. We can't, hallelujah, have the wrong behavior in the name of Jesus Christ. We have to tell Satan no, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus Christ. And we have to pray that God will send his angels, hallelujah, to take care of us, to push Satan back. Satan, go. Satan, flee. Satan, stop speaking to me. Hallelujah. Satan, go. Satan, flee. Satan, stop speaking to me in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Jesus responded, the scriptures also say, you must not test the Lord your God. Next, the devil took him to the peak of a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So God is saying that as you fast, as you pray, as you continue to tell Satan no, hallelujah, you're going to be elevated to very high places, very high mountains in the name of Jesus Christ. You're going to see the holy city in Jesus' name. You're going to see the peak of very high mountains in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God's going to bless you with the kingdoms of heaven, and God's going to bless you with very much glory in the name of Jesus Christ. And we just thank God in advance, God. We thank you, Father God, in advance, Father, for taking us to holy cities. We thank you in advance, God Almighty, for allowing us to dwell with multimillionaires. We thank you, Father God, for the wealth and the riches, God. We thank you, Father God, for the marketplace, God. We thank you, Father God, for taking us, Father God, to elevated places, God. And when we're there, God, we ask you to sustain us, God. Anybody who is planting our demise, God, anybody who is trying to cause us to be poor, to struggle in the name of Jesus, to be in famine, we cast it down now in the name of Jesus Christ, God. And we thank you, Father God, in advance, Father, for allowing us to push Satan back. Satan, go. Satan, flee. Satan, don't talk to me. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Get out of here, Satan. Hallelujah. For the scriptures say, you must worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Then the devil went away and the angels came and took care of Jesus. Hallelujah. Can we do a praise right there? Oh, God, thank you, Father, for taking care of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, for feeding Jesus. Thank you, Father God, for telling Jesus what to say to the devil. Thank you, Father God, for telling Jesus how to cause Satan to flee seven ways. Thank you, Jesus, for sending the angels to take care of Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't know about y'all, but I can't depend on my mama to take care of me. I can't depend on my daddy to take care of me. I can't depend on my brother and my sister to take care of me. I can't depend on my uncle or my aunt to take care of me. I can't depend on my friends to take care of me. I can't depend on no relative to take care of me. Hallelujah. I have to pray every day in the name of Jesus Christ. God, send your angels to take care of me. God, send the Holy Spirit to take care of me. Oh, God, send God to take care of me. And the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. When Jesus heard that John had been arrested, he left Judea and returned to Galilee. He went first to Nazareth and left there and moved to Capernaum, beside the Sea of Galilee, in the region of Zebulun and Naphtali. This fulfilled what God said through the prophet Isaiah. God is speaking through his holy word. God is speaking daily in the name of Jesus Christ. And I pray, God, will you allow for hallelujah. Oh God, thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. And I pray, y'all, that God will fulfill his goodness and his mercy in me, that he will fulfill his good promises in me, that he will fulfill his purpose, his destiny. May the conscience of God be in me. May the heart of God be in me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the Lord. May the mind of Christ be in me. May the spirit of Christ dwell in me, in my organs, in my blood, in my bones, come on somebody, in the cells in my body, come on somebody, in my skin, in my epidermis, in my dermis, in my subcutaneous tissue, come on somebody. God, dwell in my body, dwell in the human DNA, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Then it says, Jesus started walking along the Sea of Galilee. Hallelujah. He's seen some brothers fishing. Now, God said, stop fishing, hallelujah, for the fish. And he started fishing for the people. God said, come, follow me, and I will teach you how to fish for people. Right now, God, I ask you that you will bless me, that I'll be able to fish for you, that I'll be able to fish for Jesus, that I'll be able to fish for the Holy Spirit. I'm not looking to fish for fish. I'm not looking to fish for people. I'm looking to fish for God. I'm looking to fish for Jesus. I'm looking to fish for the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. That's what I want to fish for in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Then it says, God, start healing every kind of disease and illness. Oh, God, make that we ask you on today, God, that you will allow us, Father God, to be healed of every disease, every illness, every sickness, Father God. When I see myself, when I see my reflection, God, if there's any disease, if there's any illness, and if there's any sickness in my reflection, oh, God, cast it out. As I transition, God, from place to place, if there's any disease, if there's any illness, if there is any sickness, oh, God, I ask you to cast it out. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God says that he's going to heal the demon possessed. God, if there's any possession in me that is demonic, cast it out in the name of Jesus Christ. Any disease in me, Father God, that is demonic, cast it out in the name of Jesus Christ. Cast it out, God. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, y'all. Now I'm going to pray Mark 6. Hallelujah. It says, Jesus left the part of the country and returned with his disciples to Nazareth, his hometown. The next Sabbath, he began teaching in the synagogue, and many who heard him were amazed. They asked, where did he get all his wisdom and power to perform such miracles? God, we ask you that on today, God, that you will bless us with your wisdom and your power, Father God, that we'll be able to perform miracles. We'll be able to heal the sick, heal the illness, heal the diseases, God. Heal those who are epileptic, God. Heal those who are paralyzed, God. Heal those who are demon-possessed, God. We need your wisdom, God. We need your power, God, to perform these miracles in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, God. Then they scoffed and said, he's just a carpenter, the son of Mary, and the brother of James, Joseph, Judas, and Simon. Hallelujah. You got people saying, oh, God, she's just a prostitute's daughter. Oh, God Almighty, she don't got no family. She from foster care. She don't got no background. She don't got no history. You got them murmuring, God. You got them talking, God. God, you got them plotting and planning. Oh, she ain't never going to be a wife. Oh, she ain't never going to be rich. Oh, she ain't never going to be nothing. Oh, she going to end up in a ditch. Oh, she going to end up broke, busted, and disgusted. Hallelujah. She going to have to get pregnant and she going to have to leave. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, she ain't never going to be my wife. She going to be poor. She crazy. Hallelujah. But in the name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, they said the same thing about Jesus. Hallelujah. But guess what? God started healing the sick. He started performing miracles. Hallelujah. He started healing those who was demon possessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The hallelujah. Then Jesus told him a prophet is honored everywhere except in his hometown. Your own family ain't gonna honor you. The people that knew you, the people that you're sitting with, they ain't gonna honor you. That's why God says flee from them. Don't go back to them. Don't go back to your friends in the name of Jesus. Don't go back to your hometown. If they never see you again, oh well, in the name of Jesus Christ. You gotta be about your father's business. If your friends never see you again, if your family never see you again, oh well, you gotta be about your father's business. You got to be about God's business in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah in the name of Jesus Christ. God says that he's going to heal. He's going to heal the sick. Then Jesus went from village to village teaching the people. And he called his 12 disciples together and began sending them out two by two, giving them authority to cast out evil spirits. God said that he's going to give you authority to cast out the evil spirits. He's going to give you authority in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He told them to take nothing. God's going to sustain you. God's going to increase you in the name of Jesus Christ. God's going to allow you to transition. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, from village to village, city to city, state to state, continent to continent. And when you go to the place, God said he's going to allow you to cast out the evil spirits in the name of Jesus Christ. God said you're not going to have to take anything with you in the name of Jesus Christ. God said that he's going to sustain you in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you go, the Lord's going to be with you. Hallelujah. And God says that when you get there, the people are going to repent of their sins. They're going to turn to God. Hallelujah. And you're going to be able to cast out many demons and heal many sick people in the name of Jesus Christ. And when we go to these places, we have to pray, God, anybody, God, who is wanting to beheading us, God, hallelujah, because when you start performing miracles, signs, and wonders, walking in authority, casting out evil spirits, some people ain't going to like it. Some women ain't going to like it. Your family ain't going to like it. Your brother and your sister ain't going to like it. Your mom ain't going to like it. Your daddy ain't going to like it. Your aunt and your uncle, they ain't going to like it. And guess what? Some people going to be plotting to behead you in the name of Jesus Christ as they beheaded John. Hallelujah. But God says in the name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, he will protect you. Hallelujah. He will protect you. In the name of Jesus, he will protect the mind of Christ in you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Some people, they're not going to like it, y'all. They're not going to like it. Right? And they're going to be sending their children. Hallelujah. To do, the Bible said they're going to send their children. Amen. This is word, y'all. This is scripture. I didn't say it, but the Bible said it. They're going to send their children. And their children going to be dancing. Right? And the dance is going to be pleasing. Right? To the king. But we come against it now, God. Any child that's dancing for my demise, God. Any child that's dancing, God, and they're going to be wishing something or planning something or requesting something, hallelujah, that's not of God, hallelujah, that's going to cause hurt, harm, or pain, we cast it out now. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says there was a little girl, she started dancing in front of the king, and it pleased the king. And the king said, ask anything you want. And she went back to her mama. And then her mama said, oh, I want this, this, and that, right? And guess what happened? The prophet, it caused hurt and harm to the prophet. That's not of God. Jesus wasn't pleased with that. But we pray that God will protect us from the dancing of children. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Protect us, Father God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. And it says, Jesus went to a quiet place and he rested and he sought God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Late in the afternoon, his disciples came to him and said, this is a remote place. It's already getting late. Send the crowds away so they can go by to the nearby farms and villages and buy something to eat. But Jesus said, you feed them. And they said, Jesus, we don't have anything to feed them. How much bread did you have? Jesus asked. We have 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Then Jesus told the disciples to have the people sit down in groups on the green grass. And God fed them. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that, hallelujah, that there was 12 baskets of leftovers, bread and fish. And then it says Jesus walks on water. Jesus went into the hills by himself to pray. And when he was in the hills by himself to pray in the name of Jesus Christ, he started walking on the water. Take courage, says God, I'm here. He climbed into the boat and the wind stopped. After they crossed the lake, they landed at Gennesaret. They brought the boat to shore and climbed out. The people recognized Jesus at once and they ran throughout the whole area carrying sick people on mats to wherever they heard he was. Wherever he went, in villages, cities, or countrysides, the sick were healed. The demons were cast out. The evil spirits were cast out. God, we just thank you that every morning, God, that we wake up, that you allow the fringe of your robe, God, to be able to touch us. In the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord, God. Next, I'm going to be reading Psalm 77. I cry out to God. Yes, I shout. Oh, that God will listen to me. When I was in deep trouble, I searched for the Lord. All night long, I prayed with hands lifted toward heaven. But my soul was not comforted. I think of God and I moan, overwhelmed with the longing for his help. You don't let me sleep. I'm too distressed even to pray. I think of the good old days, long since ended, when my nights were filled with joyful songs. I search my soul and ponder the difference now. Has the Lord rejected me forever? Will he never again be kind to me? Is his unfailing love gone forever? Have his promises permanently failed? Has God forgotten to be gracious? Has he slammed the door on his compassion? And I said, this is my fate. The Most High has turned his hand against me. But then I recall all you have done, O Lord. I remember your wonderful deeds of long ago. They are constantly in my thoughts. I cannot stop thinking about your mighty works. Oh God, your ways are holy. Is there any God as mighty as you? You are the God of great wonders. You demonstrate your awesome powers among the nations. By your strong arm, you redeemed your people, the descendants of Jacob and Joseph. When the Red Sea saw you, O God, its waters looked and trembled. The sea quaked to its very depths. The clouds poured down rain. The thunder rumbled in the sky. Excuse me. Your arrows of lightning flashed. Your thunder roared from the whirlwind. The lightning lit up the world. The earth trembled and shook. Your road led through the sea. Your pathways through the mighty waters. A pathway no one knew was there. Oh God, I just pray on today that you will lead me through the pathways that no one knows is there. God, lead me along that road like a flock of sheep, with Moses and Aaron as their shepherds, as Jesus and the Holy Spirit as my shepherds. Oh God, I pray right now that God will lead me through a pathway that the Satan don't know about, that my mama, my daddy, my brothers and my sisters don't know about, that my aunties and my uncles and my family, my friends don't know about. Lead me through that pathway, God, that the enemy, Satan, don't know about. And God, allow Jesus and the Holy Spirit to be my shepherd. In the name of Jesus Christ, I cry out to God, and I pray that God will listen to me. In the name of Jesus Christ. Excuse me, Lord. I ask you for your unfailing love, God. God, don't reject me today. May your promises never fail me. God, be gracious unto me today and bless me with your compassion, Lord. Oh God, let your hand be for me and not against me. Allow me to meditate on your mighty works, oh God, for you are holy. Demonstrate your great wonders, God, every day among the nations, God. And thank you, Father God, for redeeming me. Hallelujah. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of the word. I pray that you guys are blessed. May no weapon formed against you prosper. May the Lord arise and shine and be gracious unto thee on today. For this is the day the Lord has made. I woke up this morning with my mind stayed on Jesus. I woke up this morning with my mind stayed on the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be blessed, guys.